To today's lecture, which is on analyzing the theme of change. So first off, we'll start by talking about what is change in literature. This might seem kind of obvious, but I want to make sure that everybody has a good understanding of this. So change can happen a few different ways. It can happen physically. Could grow taller, bigger at all. That's any kind of physical changes, your looks could change, all of that. You've got the kind of emotional changes. So you might have different emotions, different feelings. Of understandable. And then also kind of a spiritual change. That could be, if you want to think of that as like beliefs, kind of how somebody, what somebody believes, and different ideas that people have. Those ideas. Change can also happen. It could be a very small change. Small. Or it could be a really big change, right? It could happen to just one person all by themselves, or it could happen to many people, a group of people, anywhere in between as well. So the some examples of change, usually in a story, we can look at the from start to end and see different changes. Some examples that you're probably familiar with would be someone going from bad, character's bad, and ends up good. Maybe that happens to kind of one of the bad guys in the story. Could also be some interesting stories where a character is good and goes bad. You have the example, this happens in sports a lot, where you've got an underdog who people don't think is going to be successful, and they change, and they become successful. Maybe it's a sports team nobody thinks is going to win, but they do change. This one's kind of like a romance, kind of comedy sort of thing. Maybe you see it in a lot of trailers where the two people are enemies, but then guess what? They change and they become lovers. Maybe it goes the other way too. And then one that kind of happens in a lot of classical literature, like a lot of older literature, they have a hero and he kind of, because he is so brave or something and not really thinking properly, kind of becomes a tragedy. That happened a lot in a lot of older literature. So, what is character? I want to talk about that because change happens in the character. That's an important part. So, when we're analyzing change and looking at the changes, we're going to look at the character because that's where it happens. So, definition of character is a person or animal, I'm going to add to this, or a robot, or any kind of character like that, that takes part in the action. So, they're actually taking part in what goes on in the story. If a character doesn't change, that's what we call a flat character. So that's just kind of a literary term they're used. Flat character doesn't change. Maybe they're a minor character, maybe they just don't change at all. If a character does change, then it's a round character. So flat and round. If it changes, it's a round character. Just some terms they use. Some ways to analyze a character, basically. If we look at the character at the beginning, and we see what they're like at the beginning, maybe they're happy at the beginning, and then we can look at the character at the end and see how they've changed. Maybe it was that going from, they're having the emotional change, maybe. Maybe it's an unhappy story. And we can also look at, so the big thing is looking at the beginning and the end and analyzing that, but we can also look at different points in the story and see maybe how they were. Maybe they were just kind of mediocre there. maybe they had a time where they actually were really happy, but that's what made them pretty sad. Could also have physical change and everything there. Looks kind of like he grew from here to here, so. So we can analyze, what I'm saying here is we can analyze the beginning and the end, or the beginning, end, and parts in between. So things to analyze and describe, this is kind of how to analyze a character. We can analyze their appearance, describe their appearance. What do they look like? We can describe what they look like at the beginning and describe what they look like at the end of the story and see how they've changed. We can look at their actions. Do they act differently at the beginning, at the end? Do they act differently at one point and then later on they act differently? So there's change occurring there. We can look at their words. What do they say? And we can look at other people's, other characters' views about that character. So what do the other characters say about the character we're analyzing? How does that change? Do people say one thing about the character at the beginning and something else at the end? That's kind of a basic way to analyze character. But we want to look at the advanced version too. This if you're interested in going a little bit deeper and really going beyond what most people can do, then I would say pay attention here, listen to the advanced version. So if you want to analyze deeper, you're going for a 4. These are some questions that can really push it, and this is where I think it gets really fun and a little bit subtle, and we start looking behind the scenes. So what does the character believe? We can try and think and try and figure out, maybe the author doesn't say what the character believes, but maybe we can try and figure out what the character believes at the beginning and what they believe later and see how that changes. We can look at the character's motivation, their goals. What are they trying to do? We can look at that and see how that changes. We can look at how the character's actions affect other characters. So that might be something we really have to look into and find evidence of. It's pretty deep there. We could also look at, are there words repeatedly used to describe a character? Are there words that the author continues to use to describe a character? And then also, this one's kind of interesting and it's kind of fun to do in movies sometimes. Are there any items linked to a character? Maybe there's a fragile figurine that is always around when the character is doing something. Sometimes in movies it can be a color, like if anybody ever watches like Sixth Sense or something, the color red is supposed to be very linked to different actions going on there. But so characters in the same way may have items linked to them. And sometimes it's very subtle and it's kind of hidden. But so that's kind of the advanced version. That's just a basic idea and an advanced idea of how to analyze character so that we can analyze change. So change is a great theme to analyze, just to summarize what we've been saying here in this lecture. Change happens in the character, so because of that, in order to analyze change, we need to know how to analyze the character. And when looking at a character, we look at the beginning, and we can compare the character at the end, or kind of in later parts of the story, and see those examples of change.